My guest is Lisa Gerstner. And let me tell you right now, I'm blowing some of your myths, some of your excuses, because I hear, well, I would do that, but it takes too much. No, it doesn't. That's what Lisa is saying. You can do some of these things. All you have to do is have the will, Lisa, to say, look, I want to get this done, and I'm not going to stand behind that old bugaboo, well, it takes too much time, because these things don't take too much time, right?
Exactly. If you can just consciously say, okay, I've got 15 minutes right now, I'm just going to focus on this, you can get it done in a snap.
And you know, the other part of that is, I think too, Lisa, and you can check me out on this, the hard part is getting started, isn't it? I mean, if you just will yourself to start, even if it takes longer, once you're rolling, you're happy.
Yeah, that's very true. I think that's true with a lot of areas in life, you know, things at work, things like these financial tasks. If you can just convince yourself to get started, it gets better from there.
And what if I don't have any knowledge? I'm a novice. I haven't learned, didn't take time to figure out how to be a good manager. You can learn to be a good manager if you take the time to do it.
Exactly. And we have a lot of good advice on Kiplinger.com, too, where you can educate yourself on that.
Yeah, folks, that's right. You can go, listen, let this be your start to go to Kiplinger.com and look up any, and it's very comprehensive. You can go there and look up, and many of the topics we talk about here are right there, and you figure out what you want to know about. For instance, if you want to know something about estate planning, that sounds scary, but what can I do in 15 minutes there?
Well, I think with that one, you actually have a 30-minute fix. I don't know if we can do all these in 15 minutes, but we do have one where sharing some financial information with your family is important. So if you were to pass away first, you want to make sure that your spouse and your kids or anyone else important in your life is able to get into your stuff. So that could be social media. It could be your bank accounts. It could be just documents that you have that may be important after you die. So you'll want to create a master list that lets your spouse or other important people know how to get into those accounts. And also where to find any important documents, you know, where you put those. It's just good to be really prepared that way. It'll save your family some headaches in that case. And then just make sure you save it somewhere where they know how to get to it. So if you want to save it online, you could use a site like Dropbox.com and just make sure they have the password and your username to get in there, and you can save documents in there with all this information. And just make sure it's secure, you know, if you're going to be sharing passwords and things like that. Keep it in a safe place.
So you don't have to go to the bank and have a safety deposit box. You can have a safety deposit number or place on the net.
Yeah. There are websites like that one Dropbox I mentioned. It's just a storage site, so you can, especially documents, they don't take up much space, and you can keep them on there, usually up to a gigabyte for free on sites like that. So it can be a great way for everyone to really quickly and easily access that information.
Yeah, and think about this, folks. If you are living by yourself, single, or if you have a family, and something happens to you, God forbid, I know you know you're going to live forever, but somebody's going to have to follow up and say, okay, does he or she want to happen? What has he or she done? What's in place? Where do I find it? How do I get there? And can I do what they want to happen? Because if you don't tell them, Lisa, anything, I mean, then what you want to happen to you, something else can happen, right?